When was the first time you met Al Davis? When was that? When was that
called? Oh,
the Wayback Machine. Did you meet him when you were, I imagine, 2 years with the Raiders, 70 and 71?
Of course, of course. No, he. Sure. I mean, let's face it. Mr. Davis was literally there all the time. You could not be a Raider and not have met Mr. Davis.
Mm-hmm.
He was a phenomenal, phenomenal owner, a phenomenal football talent, a leader, of course, of that team and that franchise. And I just remember, I remember him as very generous because I was a free agent, and of course, as a free agent, there wasn't a heck of a lot of money there, you know. But I got a small check for signing with the Raiders. But after I made the team, not a lot of people know this, we were in training camp, and Mr. Davis was in the restaurant there. We were at that time we were in Santa Rosa, California,
mm-hmm.
At the El Rancho Motel, which we took over. And Mr. Davis was in the restaurant, and I went up to him because I'd received a check for, I think, $1,000 or $1,500. And I went up to him, and I said, Mr. Davis, thank you so much for that check. And he just looked at me almost astounded, and he said, you earned it. And that was the end of that.
Oh, and your head coach was John Madden. Do you have any recollection of a good conversation you had with him? When you first arrived, or when maybe you got sent away from the Raiders?
Well, of course, I remember it all.
Sure.
John Madden.
Yes.
Was a heck of a coach, and of course, at that time was considered a really young man, and. Daily on the field, one way or another, you'd interact with John, and I was reprimanded a number of times for penalties that were caused as a result of my exuberance. And finally, when it was time to make some decisions in the second year, you get that call, and that call is Carl Coach wants to see you in his office. Bring your playbook. At that time, we didn't have iPads and all that sort of the gear, you know. So you know that when it's bring your playbook, there are writings on the wall. But I went in, and, he was actually a very, very kind guy. The only part of the whole conversation that I think to this day still stings is he said, basically he said to me, you know, you're just too sensitive. And I went, what? I'm a football player. How the hell can I be sensitive? But on the other hand, I think he knew something about me that maybe I didn't realize at the time. Football wasn't really the calling. It was something I was able to do because I was physical and had some athleticism that was God-given. But, being in front of the camera, being on the stage, that was the calling.